Well, good evening and welcome to the second concert for the Wind Symphony this semester. You're in for a real treat tonight. Lots of variety of music and lots of just wonderful nuance between the pieces. If you see your program, the first piece, the Smetana Fanfare by Husa, is not your typical fanfare. So as you might expect from a fanfare, big brass chorale type of thing or exciting things, it starts sort of deconstructed. And so what Husa is doing is he's taking fragments of his compositional style and incorporating it into music by Smetana, which is folk-based and beautiful and nationalistic. And so the first fanfare is going to be very, almost frightening at times, very, very exciting. And then we'll contrast that with one of the most beautiful, elegant melodies ever written, the Meditation by Massenet, played by Dr. Colleen Ferguson, our professor of strings and director of the Kingsville Symphony. So the first two pieces present for you a very dramatic contrast in moods. So we hope you enjoy these two pieces. If you would help join me in welcoming to the stage one of my graduate students, Alex Nava, who is going to conduct the Husa Smetana Fanfare with the Wind Symphony. Well, help join me in welcoming Alex.
Thank you.
next piece is a real tour de force. This is composed in 2009 by Serrano Alarcón. This piece is a major symphony. It's a Spanish symphony for band, and it's composed, influenced by flamenco music. And so it'll take you through several different iterations of that and inspirations from flamenco. You'll see the clapping and the Spanish flair. We've got the cajon, which is a box drum that the player sits on, that Raymond's sitting on over here. There's electric bass, there's lots of groove. There's a fusion of funk and flamenco style in the second movement. It's got a lot of really interesting dramatic differences. The third movement is one of the most sophisticated movements in our repertoire, and I think this piece is 100 years from now, I think we'll still be looking at this piece as an important piece in the wind band rep. I hope you enjoy Duende by Luis Alarcón.
Thank you. Thank you.
Some people to recognize in the band. These are people who are either student teaching in the spring or graduating this December, and these folks have put so much time, so much energy, artistry, friendship, collegiality, all those things into their time here at the university, and they're going to do great things. They're all destined for great things. So I'm just gonna call their names off and give them a rousing applause. Give them all of the love you can. And that's Isla Coronado and the flutes. Aaron Solis, also in the flutes. Aaron. Juan Jimenez on the oboe and English horn. And euphoniums, Maritza Gonzalez. So all these folks are student teaching in the spring, so if you are a band director in the audience and you've got a job opening next year, any one of these people would do an amazing job. So thank you to those student teachers. Have a seat. And we have someone who is graduating with his master's degree in percussion, who has been with us for several years, did his bachelor's degree here, and now finishing his master's degree, and he's off to a great career as a percussionist and perhaps a college professor someday. So this is Raymond Perez in the percussion. Okay, the final piece on the concert, Elsa's Procession to the Cathedral from Lohengrin. This is one of Wagner's great operas, and this is this glorious scene where Elsa's processing, and there's just all of this drama, and you can just see the epic quality of this. There's a lot of layers in Wagner operas, and you'll hear that in this music. It sounds like this wonderful, innocent procession, but it builds, and there's like this underlying darkness, and then the end, triumphant. It is one of the great, great arrangements for a wind band from an original opera work, and so this is one little excerpt. So if you like this music, go to see Lohengrin. Hope you enjoy Wagner's Elsa's Procession to the Cathedral.